Okay, so you have to be prepared for a lot of word problems on the arithmetic reasoning section on the ASVAB. Here's one example of something that you might see when you take the ASVAB. A woman has two bank accounts. One contains $329 and awards 4% in interest each month. The other contains $921 and awards 7% in interest each month. What will the combined value of her two accounts be at the end of the month? Okay, so it's not really hard, it's just there are a lot of steps and you don't get to use a calculator. So here's what I'd say. Focus in. Don't get overwhelmed by all the different things you have to do. Start somewhere. So start with the first account that she has $329 in it and she earns 4% interest for that month. And we only have to find how much she has at the end of the month. So just 1 month. So to find how much interest she has, you take her $329 and multiply it times the 4%. But since we don't multiply by percents, you have to change that percent to a decimal by moving that decimal two places to the left. What this is going to give us is how much interest she earned on that account in that month. 4 times 9 is 36, 4 times 2 is 8, plus 3 is 11, 4 times 3 is 12, plus 1 is 13. There are two numbers behind this decimal, so your answer should have two numbers behind the decimal. So in that first account, where she had the $329, she earned $13.16. To find the total that she has in that account, you need to add how much she deposited and the interest she earned. And when adding with decimals, you have to line them up. So you can add a decimal at the end of 329, put the two zeros, so you can line it up with the $13.16. Now we just add. 6, 1, bring your decimal down, 9, 10, 11, 12, carry your 1, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so that's account 1. In account 1, at the end of the month, she had $342.16. We're going to do the same thing with account 2, it's just that the numbers are a little different. In account 2, she had $921 and earned 7% in interest. So to find the interest, multiply 921 times the 7% interest, but just like the 4%, you have to change it into a decimal. So you take this decimal, move it two places to the left, and it's 7/100. Now multiply. Also, I do want to point out that when we're multiplying with decimals, we don't line up the decimals. You deal with the decimals at the end in your product. 7 times 1 is 7. 7 times 2 is 14. 7 times 9 is 63. Plus 1 is 64. Two numbers behind the decimal. Two numbers behind the decimal. So in her second account, she earned $64.47. To find the total for that account, you just need to add the $921, add that decimal and those zeros so you can line them up, and the $64.47. So we have 7, 4, bring down your decimal, 1 plus 4 is 5, 2 plus 6 is 8, $985.47. Now, they did ask what will the combined value be. So the last thing we have to do is add those two totals together. And I'm going to do it up here so I can line them up. $342.16 and $985.47. 6 plus 7 is 13. Carry your 1. That's 6. Bring down your your decimal, 2 plus 5 is 7, 4 plus 8 is 12, carry your 1, 9, 10, 13. So $1,327.63. Now, if this were the ASVAB, I probably wouldn't have gone through all of this if these were my answer choices. You can kind of just reason yourself to the answer. We know that we want to know the combined value of her two accounts. So if you just add them without even factoring in the interest, 921 plus 329 is $1,250. So you already know it can't be A or B. Those are too low. It's not enough. Those two together are going to be more than either one of these answers. And then C is just the combined total, but it doesn't factor in the interest. So then you know C also can't be the answer, which leaves you with the only logical choice, D. Now on the actual ASVAB, their answer choices may not be that easily reasoned out, so you may actually have to work it out, which is why I did that for you, so you could see how to work it if the answer choices couldn't be easily eliminated. So, there you have an example of a word problem, of something that, the type of thing that you'll see when you take the arithmetic reasoning section of the ASVAB. The ASVAB contains two math sections, arithmetic reasoning and mathematical knowledge. Here's one example of the type of problem you'll see on the arithmetic reasoning section of the ASVAB. A woman owns a dog walking business. If two workers can walk 8 dogs, how many dogs can 3 workers walk? You see, we have 3 pieces of information here. We have 2 workers walking 8 dogs. And then we have how many dogs, so that's our question, what we're trying to find, can 3 workers walk? So we have workers and dogs, workers, and we need to find dogs. A lot of times when you have a question that has 3 pieces of information in it, where you're looking for the fourth, you're going to be setting up a proportion. 2 workers can walk 8 dogs. That's your first ratio. It's a rate. 2 workers for every 8 dogs. Now, the key to setting up a proportion is to be consistent. So, our first ratio we set up as workers to dogs, which means our second ratio must also be workers to dogs. So, we have 3 workers can walk how many dogs? Or you can put an X there. Your variable, what you're trying to find. Now, how do you solve a proportion? And there is more than one way, but the way that works every single time is to use cross products or cross multiply. 2 times X is 2X, and 8 times 3 is 24. The cross products of every proportion are equal. So now you just solve for X by undoing multiplying by 2 by dividing both sides by 2. So X equals 12. Those 3 workers can walk 12 dogs. So there you have one example of an arithmetic problem that you might see on the arithmetic reasoning section of the ASVAB. The arithmetic reasoning section of the ASVAB has a lot of word problems on it, so get ready. Here I have an example of the type of word problem that you'll see when taking the ASVAB. A steak dinner at a restaurant costs $15.99. If a man buys a steak dinner for himself and 4 friends, what will the total cost be? So they're expecting you to not read carefully. They're expecting you to see this $15.99 and this 4 and then just multiply. So what you have to notice is he's buying this steak dinner for himself and 4 friends, meaning he's buying a total of 5 steak dinners. So we need to multiply that $15.99 times 5. Now, since you don't get to use a calculator, you need to be prepared to multiply by hand. 5 times 9 is 45. 5 times 9 is 45, plus 4 is 49. 5 times 5 is 25, plus 4 is 29. And 5 times 1 is 5, plus 2 is 7. Now, where does the decimal go? When multiplying with decimals, you count how many numbers are behind the decimals in your factors, and you put that many numbers behind the decimal in your product. There are only 2 numbers behind this decimal, and that's the only decimal in my factors. So my product needs to have 2 numbers behind the decimal. So it's going to cost $79.95, which in this case would be answer D. So there you have an example of the type of word problem that you're going to see on the arithmetic reasoning section of the ASVAB. Okay, so be prepared on the ASVAB for a lot of word problems. Here's one example of the type of word problem that you're going to see on the arithmetic reasoning section of the ASVAB. It says, 4 coworkers contributed $2.58, $10.20, $19.99, and $12.89 respectively, to purchase a retirement gift for their boss. What is the maximum amount they can spend on a gift? So pretty simple. All we have to do is add all these amounts together. Really, the only thing you need to be thinking about is lining up the decimals in these numbers. And you can add them in any order you want. So I usually like to start with the biggest number for whatever reason. And I'll put the next one underneath that. Okay, so we're just adding these together. Keep in mind you don't get to use a calculator, so you are going to have to be able to add this stuff on paper. 9 plus 9 is 18. 18 plus 8 is 26. Carry the 2. That's 2 and 8 is 10, and then you have another 10 here, so 10, 25. Go ahead and bring that decimal down. And then we have 2, 4, 6 plus 9 is 15. 1, 2, 3, 4. So the most they have to spend is $45.56. And there you have an example of a word problem that you could see on the arithmetic reasoning section of the ASVAB. One of the math sections tested on the ASVAB is arithmetic reasoning. Since you won't be able to use a calculator, you'll need to be proficient at adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing by hand. Here's one example of a type of problem that you could see on the arithmetic reasoning section of the ASVAB. A florist has 733 flowers. How many full bouquets of 16 flowers can he make? So he's trying to take these 733 flowers and divide them up into bouquets of 16 flowers. Since he's dividing them up, that's what we're going to do, divide. So we need to divide 733 by 16. 16 cannot go into 7, but it can go into 73 4 times. 16 times 4 is 64. Then we subtract. 73 minus 64 is 9. Bring down the 3, and 16 goes into 93 5 times. 16 times 5 is 80. Then we subtract, and we get a remainder of 13. You can keep going, or you could stop here and you could think about what you have. You have 45 bouquets made up of 16 flowers each, and then you have 13 flowers left over. Those leftover flowers can't make another full bouquet of 16 flowers. So that means he can only make 45 full bouquets of flowers. If you wanted to continue, you would add a decimal and bring it up, then add a zero and bring it down. 16 goes into 130 8 times. And that's 128. You subtract and you get 2. And again, you could continue, but you see that you can make 45 full bouquets and 8/10 of another bouquet. But that 8/10 is not a full bouquet. So the answer here would be 45. And there you have one example of an arithmetic problem that you could see when taking the ASVAB.